Active Directory is at the heart of most Windows Server networks worldwide, and mastering it can open doors to lots of career opportunities, including systems administrator, network engineer, and cybersecurity specialist. So if you're serious about a career in IT, then mastering Active Directory can definitely give you a competitive edge. And in this video, I'm going to help you do just that. By the end of it, you'll not only be able to explain what Active Directory is, you'll also have the skills to install it and configure it in your own lab. Active Directory Domain Services, or Active Directory for short, is what we need to build a Windows Server network. Now, if we took a bunch of Windows 11 computers and network them, we can configure a peer-to-peer network like this. Now, the downside is that every PC is both a client and a server. So things like users, passwords, permissions must all be managed separately on each individual machine. Now, this is okay for very small networks, but not larger ones. Peer-to-peer networks are just not scalable. But if we add a Windows Server and Active Directory Domain Services, we can build a client-server network, a network that can be centrally managed, and one that's hugely scalable. Now, Active Directory stores information such as logins, passwords, security permissions, a whole ton of other stuff in a central data store known as the directory. This means we can manage who has access to network resources and what they can access, and all of that can be done centrally. But in order to do that, we need to install Active Directory Domain Services and configure it. So here's a quick overview of the lab setup, and I'm also going to quickly cover a few Active Directory terms that you need to know. I'm going to start off by installing the Active Directory Domain Services role. DNS will be installed because we must have a Microsoft Active Directory integrated DNS server. Our server will be promoted to become what is known as a domain controller, or DC. A domain controller is a special server that has Active Directory Domain Services installed. Think of it as the boss who's in charge, if you like. I'll show you how to create a new forest. The forest is the biggest container in Active Directory. It basically holds everything to do with Active Directory. We'll also create the first domain in the forest. This is known as the forest root domain. Now, domains are smaller containers in the forest, and they contain things like servers, computers, users, and devices so that we can organize and manage them. And I'll also show you how to name our domain using a fully qualified domain name. So if you're ready, let's get to work. I've logged into the server, and I'm going to quickly review the configuration before setting up Active Directory. Now, the server has a static IP address of 192.168.1.101 and a host name of server1. Now, it's really important to configure a static IP address and host name before installing roles like Active Directory, because changing them later on can cause issues further down the line. Now, you'll also notice here it says work group. And this means that the server is either a standalone server or part of a work group. Now, this will change after we've installed Active Directory Domain Services and made the server a domain controller. We're all good to go, so let's begin by installing the Active Directory Domain Services role. To do that, we need to click Manage and click Add Roles and Features to start the wizard. Now, this first screen basically tells us what the wizard does, and it reminds us to set a strong password for the administrator account and configure network settings and install security updates. We need to select the installation type. Now, we want to add a role, so I'm going to leave role or feature-based installation selected. Now, Server Manager is able to manage multiple servers, so we're asked to select the server from a server pool to install the role on. Now, I only have the one server, server 1, which is already highlighted, so I just need to click Next. I need to select the role I want to install, which of course is Active Directory Domain Services, and we're prompted to add additional features. Now, by the way, if you are working with multiple servers, it's worth checking the destination server at this point to check it's the correct one, server one in our case. And click next. I don't need to add any extra features, so here we can just click next. Now, this screen is quite useful. It gives an overview of Active Directory domain services and what it does, and also some useful advice. And that is to install a minimum of two domain controllers in case of a server outage, and also that Active Directory domain services must have a Microsoft Active Directory integrated DNS server. Now, if we don't have one, we'll be prompted to install one on our server, which is all good. So we can just click next. We need to review and confirm our selections. And I'm also going to tick the restart the destination server automatically if required and confirm that. And I can click install. Now this is going to take a while, so I'm going to leave it to run through and come back to it when it's completed. The ADDS role installation is complete. We now need to work through the configuration part. Now the wizard tells us that additional steps are required to make this machine a domain controller. So we need to click promote this server to a domain controller. A quick tip though, if you accidentally close the wizard by mistake, just click notifications at the top and you'll find the option there too. We need to choose a deployment operation. Now, this is a brand new Active Directory implementation, and this will be my first domain controller. So I need to choose add a new forest to create a new forest, which is the overall container for Active Directory. And I also need to create the very first domain in the forest, which is known as the forest root domain. Now I must give the forest root domain a name, and that must be a fully qualified domain name. Now one suggested method is to use a subdomain of a public registered domain name, which in my case could be something like training.ittaster.com. ittaster.com is my public registered domain name, and I've chosen a subdomain called training. Now I just want to quickly show you something here. Now, you may encounter domain names like this ending in .local, for example. Now, this is an unofficial top-level domain name, which isn't supported by internet standards. So it's best to only use them in a test lab environment for learning if you don't have a public registered domain name. And click next. Here we need to select the forest functional level and domain functional level. Functional levels determine the features and functionality available in Active Directory. And this is really important. They also determine the domain controller operating systems that are supported. Now, the forest functional level determines the functional level for the whole forest and all domains and domain controllers in the forest. The domain functional level determines the functional level for a domain inside the forest and the domain controllers in that domain. The domain functional level can be set higher than the forest functional level, but not lower. Now, the current forest functional level is set to Windows Server 2025. Which means all domain controllers in all domains within the forest must have Windows Server 2025 operating system or higher. Ideally, forest and domain functional levels should be set to the highest value your environment can support. So I'm going to stick with Windows Server 2025 for both. Now, functional levels can also be changed later on. But be extremely careful, it's absolutely critical that you do your homework first, because setting the wrong values will write off domain controllers and cause serious issues. Now, also note that DNS is selected because we must have a Microsoft Active Directory DNS server. We must also have a global catalog server. And down here, I need to choose a directory services restore mode password. This is needed to repair or restore Active Directory if we encounter problems. And click Next. The DNS options screen gives us a warning telling us a delegation for this DNS server cannot be created. Now, this is because we don't have a DNS server yet, so we can ignore it and click Next. Now the configuration wizard is going to choose a NetBIOS domain name for the domain. Now, NetBIOS is an older type protocol that maintains compatibility with older systems and software. I'm going to stick with the domain name training and click Next. We have the option to choose the location of the Active Directory database, log files, and the sysvol folder, where important files are stored and shared with other domain controllers. I'm going to stick with the defaults and click Next. I need to review my selections. All is good, and click Next. Now the configuration now needs to perform a prerequisites check before we can begin the installation. All prerequisite checks have passed successfully, and the wizard tells us that we need to click Install to begin the installation. Now this part is going to take a little while, and the server is going to reboot a few times. So I'm going to leave it to run through and I'll come back to it when it's completed. The installation process has completed, so it's time to log into the server. Now notice the login has changed. I'm now logging into the training domain, the NetBIOS domain name we configured earlier, as the domain administrator. Server Manager starts by default and it just needs to refresh and update. Now notice we have two new tiles, an Active Directory Domain Services tile and a DNS tile. I'm not going to worry about the alerts shown under services. These are likely to be services configured with the delayed start option. I'm going to go to Local Server. And I'm going to review the configuration because there's a couple more things I want to show you. Now, one of the first things to notice is that we no longer have a workgroup. Instead, we have a domain, training.ittaster.com. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is go to Tools and launch Active Directory Users and Computers. I'm going to expand the domain, training.ittaster.com. And click on the domain controllers container. This shows us the domain controllers for the domain, and we can see our server, server 1, which confirms we've successfully promoted it to be a domain controller. We can also see that it's also a global catalog server. Now, Active Directory Users and Computers is also where we manage users and computers and lots of other important server admin tasks. So that's it from me. Join me in the next video for some more Windows Server skills, and thanks for watching.